In this video, I'm gonna talk about ultra-fast lenses and are they really necessary? Hi guys, my name is Matti Sulanto. I'm a photographer and a Lumix ambassador. And in this video, I'm gonna talk about ultra-fast lenses and are they really necessary? I'm talking about, say, 50mm, f1.2, 85, 1.2, or any lens that has an ultra-fast maximum aperture. Those super-fast lenses are quite popular these days, and almost every manufacturer has at least one such lens in their lineup. And quite recently, one big manufacturer published or released a brand new 50mm f1.2 lens, and my YouTube feed was or still is full of reviews about that brand new lens. And that got me thinking, do we really need those ultra-fast lenses? They are, of course, they are awesome lenses, but they are also big and heavy and really super expensive. Once upon a time, back in the film days, those fast lenses were really practical and useful because the shallow depth of field that the fast lens offered helped a lot when you focused manually. And also the fast maximum aperture gave a really bright viewfinder image, which also helped you to focus manually. So that fast maximum aperture was really super useful, even if you never shot any images wide open, but just to be able to focus quickly and reliably was a big like a help and big bonus. But today we don't need that anymore. We have reliable autofocus on any camera or every camera, and every modern camera can focus even at f5.6 in low light reliably and quickly. So the focusing is not really a problem anymore these days. But are there some other reasons why we need those ultra-fast lenses? Let's first talk about the light gathering capabilities of a fast lens. And here when I'm talking, I'm comparing a 50mm f1.4 full frame lens to a 50mm f1.2 full frame lens. But of course, what I'm going to say can be applied to any lens or any focal length and any sensor size for that matter. But I'm comparing these two because a 51.4 is some kind of a standard fast lens, and anything faster than that is considered somehow ultra-fast or super-fast maximum aperture. But the difference between f1.4 and f1.2 is, what, about third of a stop or half a stop maximum in that ballpark anyway. And what comes to the exposure or the brightness of the image, that's pretty much within the margin of error when you are exposing your pictures. And if you have to brighten your image in post by about half a stop or third of a stop, you are not degrading the image quality in any significant way. So I think that what comes to the light gathering capabilities, it doesn't make any sense to, say, upgrade from f1.4 to f1.2. And then let's look at the depth of field. And it's pretty much the same story here. If you go from f1.4 to f1.2 or the other way around, you will either get a little bit less or a little bit more depth of field, but pretty much any lens at f1.4 or f1.2 will give you really shallow depth of field and almost too little depth of field for most purposes. So also I think that the depth of field is not a valid reason to go from f1.4 to f1.2. But what about the bokeh then? Very important. Usually A fast maximum aperture is associated with really smooth, soft bokeh. But that super smooth bokeh is not directly connected to that fast maximum aperture. The smooth bokeh is more like a lens designer's decision. He or she can design a smooth bokeh to any lens, even a slow lens, but of course a relatively fast maximum aperture is going to help to create that blurry background, and therefore also the smooth bokeh is more pronounced when the aperture is relatively fast. But the smooth bokeh is more like a designed feature, and sometimes a fast lens can have a worse bokeh than a slow lens, and vice versa. So the fast maximum aperture itself doesn't create smooth bokeh. That comes from the design or the designer of the lens. And then about the image quality, I mean sharpness, which is also important. The second most important, right after the smooth bokeh. And it is a fact that it's easier to design a slow lens than a fast lens. It's exponentially more difficult to design a fast lens than a slow lens. However, most of these super fast lenses are also kind of a flagship products, and a lot of design effort goes into those lenses, and they tend to be optically also superior, or at least as good as any slower lenses. So if you buy one of these super ultra fast lenses, you are probably going to get also awesome image quality with that lens. And then there are a couple of other considerations as well. Those ultrafast lenses are big, heavy, and expensive. But in some situations, they are going to give you some street credibility, and it's also a status symbol. So it might make sense in that regard to buy such a lens. And also, the build quality tends to be really good because, like I said, they are usually flagship products, and top-notch build quality usually comes with that kind of a product as well. And also, some of these ultra-fast lenses are also a nice-looking object, so you might just want to buy them and put it on a shelf and just look at it, because it's a pretty nicely designed object. So I guess my conclusion with this extremely important topic is that those super fast lenses can be or probably are awesome lenses, but it's not that extra third of a stop or half a stop that makes them special. It's the general build quality probably, and the image quality, what comes to sharpness and other optical qualities, it's that kind of things that makes them special, because they are top of the line flagship products, and they are well built, and a lot of design effort went into them, so they are bound to be awesome products. And also, I guess we need those lenses, at least for the manufacturers, to show what they can design or build. But these are just my ramblings about this very important topic. Please let me know your thoughts about this in the comments down below. Have you bought a 50 f1.2 or something similar ultrafast lens? And do you think they are really necessary these days, or if they are not necessary or whatever? Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.